I took Microsoft's 6-hour Copilot course for you. And in this video, I'll be breaking down for you the key points from the course so you have a clear understanding of how Copilot can fit into your daily workflow and simple prompts that you can use at work starting tomorrow. Because the truth is, those who have learned how to leverage AI, they are not just more productive, they are also getting promoted faster. So let's make sure that you are not falling behind. Now, the first module is pretty straightforward and it covers the basics of Copilot. What is good to know about Microsoft Copilot is that it's an AI assistant that lives already within the Microsoft 365 apps that you already know. And what makes it really powerful compared to other AIs is that it's context aware, which means that it doesn't just answer your questions, but it can go through your emails, through your files, presentations, and essentially this means that it can give answers that are relevant to your work and not just some generic AI answers that you would get in other systems. This module also covers how to get Copilot and the different variants there are. I'm not gonna dive too much into detail, but essentially there's two modes of Copilot. So on one side you have Copilot Pro, that is the version for individuals, and it integrates with Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and so on. It already offers some of the basic functionality of Copilot integrated into those apps. And on the other side, you have Copilot for Enterprise. And this is really the game changer because this version connects to your organization's data, meaning your files, meetings, team messages, and so on, while of course being compliant with the privacy, security, and the permissions that your company provides. So the main point of this module is to show that Copilot is not just another regular chatbot, but it's a new interface for productivity. And eventually, once you learn how to use it, it can almost become like a teammate where you can delegate your tasks to. Okay, so now that you know what Copilot is and how to get it, module 2 focuses on providing already some value, starting with PowerPoint. Of course, one of the abilities that Copilot provides in PowerPoint is creating slides from scratch. Here, for example, you can use prompts like create a presentation about such topic, and it will generate some slides for you, which is nice, but to me, when I look at the outcome, to be honest, I don't find it really useful in a real job. However, I think where the strength of Copilot really comes in is in the ability of referencing other files. Like for example, create a presentation based on the key points of this McKinsey report. And Copilot essentially will read through a document, pull the main ideas, and create already quite some decent slides, which to me, they are still not perfect, but honestly, it gives you a massive head start. And what is also nice is that it can also take into account your corporate branding when you're creating the slides. So for example, you can start first by opening the PowerPoint template of your company, and then when you ask to create a 10 slide presentation about something, you will see that Copilot will generate the slides using your corporate branding. Now, once the main slides have been built, you can also go a level deeper with prompts like rewrite this slide to make it clearer for a non-technical audience. Or for example, you can also try things like condense this text, which can help you eventually fine-tune the deck. And to me, what is also nice is that you can also use Copilot when creating the presentation as a bit of a creative partner. So for example, you can ask him questions here on the side panel, like for example, give me 3 icebreaker questions for a global audience related to this presentation topic. And as you can see, Copilot will create some ideas and then you can pick the one you like the most, and you can ask Copilot to add a slide at the beginning using the idea you like the most. So for example, you could say, use the first idea and create a slide with a relevant image, and please add this one as the opening slide. And just like that, you can see Copilot just created the first slide, adding an image and the icebreaker question. It's still not perfect, but again, it gives you a massive head start and then you can just tweak some things. Now, of course, these are just some of the functions, but there are so many more. Like for example, you can ask for a summary of the entire presentation. You could ask Copilot to add speaker notes for each slide, or you could also use it as a sparring partner to basically help you prepare for the actual moment where you need to present this in front of an audience. Overall, these are some of the most interesting prompts that I saw in this module, and I'm just putting here on the screen so you can also try them for yourself. Now, moving on, the next module is about Microsoft Word. And to me, this module was not so interesting because, to be fair, in my real job, I don't use Microsoft Word so much. But if you actually do in your job, I think it has some features that are quite interesting to dive into. Now, one obvious one is the ability to summarize long documents. So imagine, for example, that you have just received a really long report like this one here on screen, and you don't have the time to read it in full. All you have to do is just go to Copilot and say, hey, summarize the key points of this 20-page document. And as you can see, it takes a bit to think, but eventually you get a summary of that 20-page document. So you don't really have to go through all the details, but here you have like key highlights that you need to know about it. And of course, it can also help you in content creation. So let's say that in your company, you are maybe in charge of the blog of the company, and you know what the next issue should be about, but you're struggling a bit to create the first draft, that's where Copilot can help you. So for example, you could add a few bullet points with the key elements that you want to talk about, like what you see in this file, and then simply you could prompt Copilot something like, write a 500-word blog post about the benefits of using AI in the workplace. And it will think a bit, and just like that, Copilot will give you a solid first draft to work with. And of course, this is just the first draft that then you can fine tune further, either manually or using more prompts. Like for example, you could ask Copilot to rewrite certain paragraphs or even change the tone depending on your audience, so you can make it more formal, more technical, more informal, more playful, depending in the end on what's the goal of your document. Now, one other example from this module that I found interesting is how Copilot can help you transform certain text into a table. So let's say for example, you have an action list like this one. You could prompt something like generate a table from this data with headers for the action, the owner, and a deadline. And just like that, you can see Copilot is generating the table that you are actually looking for. You can literally copy paste that into an email, for example, and just send it to your colleague. So even though Microsoft Word might seem a bit basic, when you pair it with Copilot, it can become a real huge time saver, especially if your job is about content creation or writing reports or stuff like that. And again, I'm listing here some of the prompts that I found interesting from this module. And again, feel free to try by yourself. The next module is about Microsoft Teams. And if you work in a corporate setting like me, probably you will find this one very interesting because probably you're spending your day in chats, in calls, in meetings, in notifications from channels and so on, and trying to keep up with everything that's going on. And here is where Copilot plus Teams can become a real game changer for you. This module gives a high level overview of prompts and features that you can use in Microsoft Teams along with Copilot. So for example, one of the first ones that it shows is that you can use Copilot to help you draft some messages in Teams. And the way it works is pretty simple. You can just write something in the text box and you can press the Copilot edit button, which will allow you to rewrite the message or adjust it based on the tone of voice that you want to give it. So it's a bit similar to what you could do in Word, but in this case, in a Microsoft Teams interface. Another interesting feature of Copilot in Teams is the ability to summarize the content of chats or channels. So for example, let's say that you spend the full day in a workshop and you were not on top of your messages in Teams, and then you go back to your laptop and you see a chat with, let's say, 150 messages. Here, Copilot can help you summarize exactly what has happened in that conversation. So for example, you could just prompt Copilot with something like, summarize this conversation, what decisions were made, what is still pending, and in just a few seconds, you get a clear overview of everything that has been discussed in that Teams chat without the need of having to scroll through all the conversation and read every single message, which is, I think, quite interesting. Now, when you're in live meetings, Copilot can also help you almost like a virtual assistant. You can ask it to manage your agenda, to keep track of time, or even it can help you privately to guide a bit the discussion. Like, for example, if a meeting starts to lose focus, you can write something like, what are questions that I can ask to move this meeting forward? Or if you have joined a meeting halfway through it and you don't know exactly what has been discussed in the first, let's say, 10-15 minutes that you missed, you can also prompt Copilot with something like, summarize the key points that have been discussed so far. And Copilot will show you on the side, on a window that is only visible to you, what are the key points that have been discussed so far, so you can quickly catch up on what happened in that meeting. And the nice thing is that once the meeting is over, still Copilot is working for you. So after the meeting, you can ask it something like, list all the action items we discussed and assign deadlines and owners for each action. And it will return a full list of action items with owners and deadlines that you can then copy paste to Outlook and just send as a follow-up email. This module just gives a very high level overview of what Copilot and Teams can do together. And to me, to be honest, this is one of the most powerful combinations because like I said at the beginning, as a corporate employee, I spend most of my day in chats, in team meetings, reading through channels, finding documents in Teams. So having an AI assistant that can help you in pretty much almost any task in this app, I think this is really powerful. Now, moving on, the next module in the list is Copilot plus Excel. What is important to know before diving into specific use cases is that to be able to use Copilot in Excel, you need your data to be formatted in a specific way. Mainly, you need to format your data as a table or as a supported range, and only then Copilot is able to read the data and do something with it. At first, the module just showcases some basic prompts, and I'm going to show you also a couple of them. Like, for example, you have a table like this, and you can say, highlight the highest values in the sales column, and you can see it's thinking a bit, and now it's highlighting the top values in the sales column. Or you can also do things like sort from largest to smallest value, which, to be honest, these kind of prompts are fun to try once or twice, but I would say they aren't really useful. And to me, for example, something like sorting, I find it way easier in the traditional way. Now, if you ask me, when it gets really interesting is when you can ask Copilot to generate insights based on a specific dataset. Let's say you have a table like this one, you could ask Copilot some basic questions like, can you highlight if there are any outliers in this dataset? And Copilot will think a bit, And as you can see, it's already highlighting that yes, indeed, there's a couple of outliers in this dataset. And this was just one option, but there are many more interesting problems you could try to get insights from your dataset. But to be honest, if you have used Excel before and have a solid understanding on their basic functions and how to do some analysis, I don't feel this will save you that much time, and I personally find it easier to use Excel regularly. However, to me, what was really interesting from this module was to see the ability of Copilot to generate any kind of formula on the spot, fully tailored for your dataset. So let's say that you're working with a messy table and you need to create a new column showing the growth rate or the average revenue per client. You could simply ask something like, create a formula to calculate the quarter over quarter growth, and hit enter, and Copilot will write it for you. And this was just a very basic example, but sometimes if you need really specific formulas for your dataset, you don't need to go anymore to Google or Stack Overflow and try to find the formula and then try to adapt it to fit into your specific dataset. In this case, you can just go to Copilot and it will handle it for you. So for example, you could say something like, write a custom formula to flag any rows where sales have dropped by more than 15% compared to the previous period. And it's thinking for a bit, and there you go, Copilot just delivers. And literally you can copy paste this formula into your Excel file, and it just works because it's tailored to your data set and to your specific table. So for me, to be honest, just this feature alone makes Copilot combined with Excel one of the most powerful integrations in this suite. And yes, in case you're wondering, Copilot can also help you in creating pivot tables and drawing some conclusions from the data set that you have in that pivot table. So essentially, when you combine Copilot with Excel, to me, what is really interesting is that you can shift your mindset from being the guy who's just crunching all the numbers and trying to do all the analysis to letting Copilot do that for you and becoming the decision maker based on the insights that Copilot is giving you. And in case you're interested, these are again some of the prompts that I found the most interesting, and you can also try for yourself. Moving on, the sixth module is about Outlook and Copilot. This module basically goes through some high-level examples on how Copilot can help you manage your inbox. For example, let's say that you have been away for a few days, like you were on holidays, or maybe you just had one of those days that you were in a full day workshop and you were not really on top of your inbox, and then you come back and you have a ton of emails to go through. Instead of scrolling through everything and trying to get all the context and everything, you can ask Copilot something like, summarize this conversation. Are there any deadlines that I should know about? And just like that, Copilot is giving you the key points, the action items, and any important dates. So there is no more digging through the replies to find that one email that you missed. You can just ask Copilot and it will surface that data for you. But Copilot and Outlook, it's not just about catching up with your inbox, but it's also about helping you write better emails. Like, let's say you need to draft a new email for your team. You could start with something simple like, please write a follow-up email thanking the team for today's attendance to the workshop and emphasizing everything that we have achieved in it based on the minutes that I took over here. And after a few seconds, you can see it gives you a full draft, which is professional and clear. And if you don't like the tone, you can ask it to revise. Like, for example, you can write something like, please make it more concise, or you could also say, add a bit more warmth to the message. And what is also interesting is that Copilot comes with a coaching function in Outlook. So when you're drafting an email, you can ask it to rewrite certain parts, but you can also say, hey, give me some coaching on how I'm writing my email. And you will see how it creates a list of potential improvement points and some feedback on how you can craft a better email for this time or for next time. I think Copilot and Outlook combined also have a lot of potential. And here is a list of the prompts that I found interesting in this module that you could also try for yourself. And moving on, we have module 7, which is the last module of the course, and it focuses on Microsoft Chat. Until now, we have looked into how Copilot fits into the different Microsoft apps like Word, Excel, Teams, PowerPoint, and Outlook. But next to that, you have Microsoft Chat, which you can think of it as the command center of Copilot and integrates everything into just one place. There's basically two ways to interact with Microsoft Chat. You can either do it on the website version or in Teams, which probably is the most accessible one for everybody. Now, let me show you how powerful this can be by going through some of the examples of the module. To begin with, Microsoft Chat is, of course, also context aware, meaning you can ask something like, summarize all the emails and Teams chats that I got from yesterday. Please highlight anything that needs my attention. And it will pull together the key points from both channels, from Teams and from Outlook, so you don't have to go juggling between both apps. You could also ask other things, like for example, what are the key updates on the Q1 product launch? And Copilot will search across your emails, your messages, any documents you have, and give you a consolidated answer based on everything that it could find. Now, next to this, it comes with two modes, web and worry. So let's say if you are doing some research on competitors or key market trends, you can switch to the web version and ask Copilot, and it will pull data from the live internet using Bing Search, which, like everybody knows, it's the best search engine out there. But leaving jokes aside, you can go to Microsoft Chat web version and you can ask something like, find recent news about communication technology trends. Or you could also ask, generate a list of our top 5 competitors and their latest strategies. And it will pull that information for you, and it will also list all the sources. So even though it comes from Bing, you can still check if the sources are legitimate. And then if you want, you can also switch to the work version, and then it will rely on the data of your organization. So basically, Copilot Chat is not just some fancy chatbot, but if you use it well, it can be a tool that sits not just on top of your organization data, but it can also pull data from the internet, putting all together for you and doing things that otherwise it would take you forever to do on your own. And once again, here's a list of some of the prompts that I saw in the module that you could try next time that you're using Copilot Chat. And that was it. You have now officially completed the Microsoft Copilot training, and I just saved 6 hours of your time. I hope by now you feel inspired to try some of these prompts and use cases on your own. And if you got any value of this video, please drop a like, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.